Hello, it's Nitro99 again, and I'll be doing a review on the LEGO Pirates Loot Island. This is mainly just to show the cannon function, which I forgot in my Imperial flagship. And also, since that review wasn't that good, but I'll explain that in my blog. So, here's the minifigures. I have one soldier, printed shako, and printed torso. Nice sword, a binoculars eyepiece. Back printing, blue epaulette, nice figure. Here you have the castaway guy. New pants. I don't think these pants are in any other set. The torso is the same as some of the other pirates, and I'll show in a minute. And his face is the same as the beggar in medieval market village. And sick. Sorry about that. It's hard to get their heads off when they have a beard. That face. Come on, show up. That guy. And this is the torso. It's that regular pirate torso. And the beard and the hat. Cap. Here we have another pirate. Same head as the lieutenant in the Imperial flagship, and he's also a pirate in many sets. Nice torso, musket, and sword, green hat. And you get this printed map piece. Nice. You get a dark green crocodile. Tail moves, mouth moves. Nice. And you get this boat. It's blue. Strange color, but I guess it's okay. Printed flag. Two oars, two cannons, balls, and here's the cannon. And I'll show you the cannon this time. You get one of these and you load it in the cannon. And you pull this back here. Oops. And as you can hear, it hit the box. With enough force, this can actually shoot pretty far, like about a yard or so. And it works pretty well. Just pull it back. And see there. It's very nice. It moves up and down. So, showed you the cannon. Oh, and this swivels. So, on to Loot Island. I actually don't really like Loot Island because, unlike the older Pirates hideouts, the classic Pirates, this one doesn't really have much charm. It has this lame catapult up here. You're supposed to flick. It doesn't work very well, and this keeps falling out. So I just get rid of that. And it has the dock is kind of nice. But the main attraction to the set is the base plate. This first time it's been made. The only flaw I can say about it is these things. They can be removed, and they stick in with a Technic pin. It'd be nicer if there was just a giant, studs all around here. And up here as well, if there's this all studs, but so this just sits there, and it's not that cool. You have two jewels and the skull piece, flame cooking a fish, some fauna back here, printed pirate flag, and over here, even though this is supposed to be kind of a jail as well, I mean, it's easy for the pirate, the soldier, to escape. And seems like a pretty dumb place to hide treasure, but I guess pirates aren't that smart. Here's the gold, four gold pieces and two nice crystals, like a topaz and citrine or something, blue citrine. But it's the same color as the one that was in the Imperial flagship. It's a very nice color. And that's about it. There's another binocular up there. And that's the back of the print plate inside. Even though they have like stud tiles there, there's no studs. So the plate is nice, but it could be much better. And there's nothing back. I mean, it's flat. If you had two of these, you could put them together. But I'm not going to spend another $20 to get two. And this only has 142 pieces. the base plate takes up a lot of that price. Oops. So here, figures again, back of the box, shooting that stupid catapult, putting the prisoner in the there, but even though you can escape out back, or in the cannon, there's the pieces you get. He's fighting in the water. And yeah, there's Brick Rear's bounty. And I hope you enjoyed this review. Just a little something to show you the cannon, and that's about it. Pirates are going to be discontinued soon, but of course Pirates of the Caribbean licensed series will be out next summer, around the time the new Pirates of the Caribbean movie on Stranger Tides comes out. So please rate, comment, subscribe, and see you later. Bye.